Now, a new study highlights a troubling spike in babies born addicted to painkillers. Ray Suarez has the story.
On average, every hour, a baby is born in the U.S. addicted to opiates, a class of drugs that ranges from heroin to prescription painkillers like Vicodin. A new study published this week in the Journal of the American Medical Association looked at the growing number of mothers taking painkillers and the babies born hooked on drugs. The lead author of the study is Dr. Stephen Patrick, who practices neonatal perinatal medicine at the University of Michigan, and he joins me now. Dr. Patrick, welcome. What did you study to conclude that the number of babies with drugs in their system hadn't just increased over the last decade, but nearly tripled?
Well, we looked at neonatal abstinence syndrome, which is a drug withdrawal syndrome that newborns experience after they're born. It usually happens after newborns have been exposed to opiates during the pregnancy. So over the last decades, from 2000 to 2009, we found that the rate of babies diagnosed with drug withdrawal grew by threefold. In 2009, we noted that more than 13,000 babies were born with drug withdrawal, or about one baby born per hour.
What drugs are we talking about here? Are they drugs we already knew Americans were taking a lot more?
Well, the other part of our study, we looked at mothers using opiates at the time of delivery, and that increased fivefold over the last decade. One thing that we were not able to do was to tell the exact type of opiates. But opiates are a broad class, so it includes everything from heroin to opiate pain relievers like Vicodin and even methadone.
Are these illicitly acquired drugs, prescription drugs?
You know, unfortunately, from our study, we were not able to determine that. That was a limitation of our study. What we do know, looking at data that's been reported by the Centers for Disease Control, we know that over the last decade, prescription opiates have quadrupled in sales, and deaths attributed to prescription opiates have also quadrupled. So we think that this might be one explanation for the rapid increase that we see.
If we already knew there was a problem with these drugs, was it inevitable they were going to turn up in the bloodstreams of babies?
You know, I don't know if I would say that. I would say that, you know, the increases, I think this study shows that multiple people are affected. And I hope that this study gets attention to think about ways that we can prevent this. I think that this should get the attention of federal and state government policymakers to think about ways that we can control our opiates maybe in a more optimal way. You know, often in our health system, we react to problems. And I think that this study calls for a public health approach. Many states are already doing things to limit abuses of opiates, such as registries of prescriptions that are written so that we can tell if someone is doctor shopping or going from one doctor to another to get the same opiate prescription. It's things like these and strategies to limit opiate exposure that will prevent this problem way before it becomes an issue, you know, especially in our newborns.
Many states have moved to a more punitive, more criminal justice-based response to women who take drugs during or after pregnancy. Is that part of the answer?
I think, you know, blame is not always helpful. What I think would be most helpful is, again, thinking about this from a public health perspective, preventing this before it even becomes an issue. And I think that does come from, you know, from a public health standpoint, limiting opiates before they're even used. And I think that we can do this through robust public health programs to think about the way we prescribe and think about statewide programs that can limit abuses and diversion of these drugs to things that are illegal uses.
What are the consequences for newborns who've been exposed to drugs during their mother's pregnancy?
So newborns who experience drug withdrawal often are more irritable, they're inconsolable, they sometimes have breathing problems, they oftentimes have difficulty feeding and loose stools, and rarely they can have seizures. We also know that they're more likely to be born low birth weight.
Your study found significant increases in the cost of caring for those children. What's driving those increases?
Well, we found that from 2000 to 2009, the cost, or the average hospital bill, actually, for these newborns across the entire United States increased from $190 to $720 million. We think that this increase is probably driven by the average length of hospital stay. So these babies, on average, had a length of stay of around 16 days compared to all other U.S. hospital births of 3 days, as well as the rapid increase in the sheer number of these babies.
What's the long-term prognosis for these babies? Do we even know?
That's a great question. So, you know, the data is still out there. I think this study, I hope, will gain attention to this issue and get more research dollars to study this. We know that over the last couple of decades that there have been some studies that have followed babies that have been exposed to opiates and found that there are developmental delays. But there are also studies that show that there are no issues. So what we really need are big, robust studies to follow these babies as they grow into school age, into adulthood, to really get an idea of what the consequences are beyond the time of birth. You know, we don't know what the consequences of some of these opiates are, and we don't always know the exact consequences of some of the medicines that we use to treat these babies either.
We know many American women get little or no prenatal care. Should the prenatal care that women taking drugs are getting include more advice, more screening, more diversion to lower the number of babies born with drugs in their system?
You know, prenatal care is a good thing, and I think anything that allows women to, you know, spend more time with their obstetrician and get good counseling will improve care. So certainly from my perspective as someone who takes care of babies after they're born, you know, knowing some of these issues before the babies are born helps me identify and treat these babies most appropriately.
Dr. Patrick, thanks for joining us.
Thank you very much.